on Kolento, but we'll have to see how that match is going to play out. I'm joined with Chalky once again, and of course, Raynad's joining us back on the desk. We traded out Templestorm members. How you guys doing?
Doing great.
I'm good, man. It's nice to be back.
It's getting pretty late. Caffeine's starting to wear off. I ate some almonds earlier. Those have already made it through my system. All the energy's gone, man. But this last match is going to be crazy hype. Kolento versus Domdus. The winner of this next match is going to move on to the playoff stage, do that round of eight. So we're going to take a look at the bracket to see what we've seen so far in Group B. Domdus had a tough road because he went down to the losers match first off. And Kolento had a 3-0 followed by an 0-3. So judging by that logic, he's going to win 1.5 games this next series.
Well, I don't know if that holds up.
Really? At least he's consistent.
At least he's consistent. Yeah, Kolento, known as one of the most consistent players, so wouldn't be surprised if that happens. But what are you guys' thoughts on this play? Chalky, who do you think is going to win?
I think Kolento, probably the favorite here. Hopefully it's a bit closer of a series than he's had.
I think it could go either way. Dom is a pretty solid player, and I mean, I like the decks that he brought. He seems like comfortable with what he's bringing. I think that if Kolento was a favorite, it's only by a little. And it could really go either way.
So Kolento has been the only player so far who's brought Priest, and it's sort of been hit or miss for him. In the first match, he had like the God draw. He had Northshire Cleric, Injured Blademaster, Circle of Healing.
And that Priest deck, I think, is actually Domdus' best chance of winning. If he has an edge, it's like, yeah.
Okay, Chalky.
So Priest, probably the most important deck for Kolento to win with. If that happens off the bat, really good for him.
Yeah. Well, let us know what you guys think of Priest and of this next matchup. You can tweet at us using the hashtag HLS, and make sure you follow us on Twitter at ESL Hearthstone. It's been a long day, but I know we have one more exciting match coming, and then, of course, a weekend full of Hearthstone action. So make sure throughout the weekend you guys are making sure you join in on the conversation and let us know what you think. Also, we'd like to give a shout out to our sponsors. Plantronics and Gigabyte are making all of this possible. We had a chance to fly 16 of the world's best players out to Burbank, California, and have them compete for $25,000, and it would not be possible without the guys over there. So if you want some cool gear from those guys, some Plantronics headsets or some Gigabyte motherboards, make sure you check out those links below or head to legendaryseries.com and grab yourself some of that. But Domdus just played a match, so he's going to take a moment to reset and get ready for his match against Kolento. But in the meantime, while I have you guys here to pick your brains, I want you guys to tell me what you think is the up-and-coming deck. What do you think is going to be the next big thing? What's the next Patron Warrior, Chalky?
Well, I don't think anything's really going to reach that level, but
if Patron Warrior was deleted from the game, Patrons and Warriors.
Well, Hunter's really good, too.
And Hunters were deleted also. What would it
be? Murloc Mage.
Murloc Mage. Yeah. Okay.
Yeah, Murloc Mage. Oskaka beat me with that in a tournament once.
Okay. That is embarrassing.
So forget
it. It was pretty embarrassing. He only used it because he didn't have a collection on NA. So, yeah.
Yeah, that's actually even more embarrassing. That little fact that you added on didn't help your argument at all.
And I've lost a lot, TJ. I'm over the embarrassment part of that.
Did you take second place in that tournament?
I did. That was the finals.
Yeah.
You know how much money I got?
How much money?
$0.
$0. Ouch. Well, it's also funny that you guys are here because
speaking of Warriors.
No, you can't cut me off on that one.
Okay, go ahead, TJ.
I was going to say the history between Chalky and Raynad here. It's really cool to have you guys both in the desk.
It's a great love story, yeah.
Yeah, because
it
was actually my first Hearthstone casting experience was the NESL King of the Hill. Mm. And a famous match in the NESL King of the Hill series was one of Chalky versus Raynad.
Mm.
Yeah.
And remember that.
Chalky actually
won. The difference between a pro and a streamer, right?
Oh, man.
It's brawl rolls.
Yeah.
I remember that match. That was an interesting metagame. Was that before or after NatPaggle?
That was me playing Paladin, was what that metagame was. That was...
I remember Karen Hand.
That was after NatPaggle.
It was after NatPaggle.
Yeah.
Yeah, good times, good times.
Good times.
Glad we could all positively reminisce about the times. But we are jumping into the first match of this last series of the day between Kolento and Domdus. It is going to be Warrior versus Warrior.
Yep. Different versions from both players. Kolento with the patron, Domdus with the control.
Well, this is exactly what Domdus wants, bringing Control Warrior to the table. The main reason to bring the deck is because it's favored in the Warrior Mirror over Patron. But Patron can still win. There are still very cheesy, frothing, berserker-related things you can do to win. But I'm going to give the edge to Domdus by a pretty big margin, actually, like 75-25 probably.
Wow. I think it's a little bit closer, but Domdus's hand is pretty solid. Kalento's hand, I mean, Armorsmith doesn't really do anything. Loot Hoarder just cycles. He's going to need a lot of help.
Yeah, the tournament has basically come down to the players that, I think it was Trump who said it earlier, the players that brought Patron Warrior versus the players that prepared for Patron Warrior and brought deck lineups to sort of match against that.
Yeah, it reminds me of the Miracle Rogue meta. And usually, Miracle Rogue players were the winners, not the counter players.
Yeah, I agree with that too. That's, every time I've just played the broken decks, I've done better than trying to counter them.
That tends to be the overall solution, but it can feel good if you kind of counter and win.
Yeah. Well, Raynad said the week that he actually won his week of the Legendary Series that qualified him was the first time he had ever played Patron Warrior.
Yeah, I played like two games with it, and I had to craft Golden Patrons halfway through that tournament. And yeah, I net-decked Saiyan's list, and I learned as I went. Miss Lethal and stuff. Apparently Warsong buffs your dudes. It gives them charge if it's dead, which is cool. Like if you whirlwind killing it. I didn't know that.
Yeah, I think they all resolve at the same time is why it does that.
Well, I'm glad you learned that while you were playing a game of Patron Warrior in a tournament.
Yeah, it's a solid sign that a deck's a little overpowered if I can win tournaments with it.
There you go. That should be the benchmark. Right. Oh, Raynad won a tournament with it?
Nerf.
Nerf it to the ground.
It did it with Zoo, man. I miss Soulfire.
Oh, man. Soulfire. Bad experiences with that, TJ.
Mm-hmm. Legendary Series and, of course, WCA. I think in the past, like, 3 weeks, out of 8 Soulfires I think I've seen in competitive play, 7 of them have discarded the other Soulfire.
There's not much change up in there.
Yeah, exactly. 1 mana, yeah, but still, you should only run 1 Soulfire because the second one's always getting discarded.
Well, this Belcher's a problem. Usually it's a card that's pretty weak in the Warrior Mirror, but in this case, I mean, Kalento just doesn't have a weapon, and that's exactly what you want to mulligan for, so that's pretty unlucky for him. He's not at one at this point. It's pretty deep into his deck.
Yeah, he has, like, no way to clear this. Like, he could execute it, but that's not... You're not happy to do that.
Yeah, he's thinking through all his options, and looks like he isn't sure yet. All the options look pretty bad.
Yeah. He's got some pretty good combos later on, because he's already got Warsong Commander, Frothing Berserker, which you said the Frothing Berserker shenanigans are one of the ways that Grim Patron Warrior can overcome this matchup. But...
Yeah, it's a really interesting dynamic, because you want to use your cards like Inner Rage in situations like this to draw, and you want to be using your Whirlwinds to set up Patrons and stuff, but like the more combo pieces you use up, the... like more impossible it becomes to actually kill the Control Warrior player, because eventually there's such a high life total that you can burn your whole hand on a combo and it's not lethal, and they just play Brawl and you're kind of out of the game at that point.
Did Domdus run Double Brawl? I know I've seen one Double Brawl today. Was he the Control Warrior player?
I think he was the Double Brawl.
Okay.
Yep, he definitely was.
That helps the matchup even more. Matchup that was already favored on one side.
Yeah, that's how you know he's targeting specifically this deck with his lineup.
He's got Handlock and Druid as well.
It can help against Handlock sometimes. Like Warlock in general, Double Brawl. Oh no, Domdus. Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I know most people agree Handlock's favored for the Handlock versus Patron, but Druid kind of, some people just think, like, even though it's Druid, you're still favored. Just make a bunch of Patrons.
Yeah.
Patron Warrior against Druid?
Yeah.
I think Patron Warrior is heavily favored there.
Yeah.
Seems pretty unintuitive. Like, Warrior and Druid forever have been... It's been bad for the Warrior.
Druid has been pretty terrible today.
Yeah.
Has it?
Yeah.
I suppose. Did we have Ramp Druids or Fast Druids?
Mixture.
Both. Okay. Well, Lead Paint was, like, the only Ramp Druid with a bunch of taunt.
Yeah.
And he just got smashed. Couldn't win with it.
poor guy.
Well, he's got some options here. Kolento's deciding whether he wants to play this Dread Corsair into the weapon, whether he wants to drop the Berserker before it has charge. But he's going to hold on to that combo. He's got the Whirlwind and everything.
Yeah, I think he probably wants to set up a big Battle Rage turn because he needs to get really deep into his deck here.
Yeah. It's tough to do without Emperor. Definitely a key card in the Warrior Mirror.
Yeah.
Things are going exactly as Dom just wants, though. Just taking the game slow, armoring up, killing whatever threats Kolento plays, because the longer the game goes, the more it favors Domdus, honestly.
Flood and Thunder.
Yeah. I guess that's the game plan. Flood the board.
And Thunder him.
Don't know how he's going to Thunder him, but that'd be nice, too.
Mm-hmm.
Well, Domdus has been paying attention. He knows that Kolento still has access to coins, so he is threatening Warsong plus Grim Patron next turn, but Domdus isn't too afraid of that because he's got the Brawl plus Weapon. Can't play both next turn, though. This does open up Domdus to being top decked and wrecked by Grim Patron.
Yeah, but I mean, he's going to be on 7 mana next turn.
Be able to Shield Slam whichever one lives.
And oh, that's a good point. Yeah, he's got the Shield Slam. So yeah, the weapon doesn't matter at all.
The other really nice thing is that since Kolento played an Armor Smith so early, he's gained so much armor that he actually hasn't taken damage, which is bad.
Oh, yeah.
And Battle Rage isn't going to draw that extra card.
Yeah, because he didn't draw weapons early.
Yep, couldn't face tank anything.
Yeah.
And as a control warrior early on, you just never want to hit their face.
Mm-hmm.
Alright, well, Emperor could be an important draw. Definitely going to enable some combo shenanigans, which is pretty much Patron Warrior's plan for winning. I guess you have to attack a minion here. I guess you attack the 3-1 so that your Emperor doesn't get traded for on board.
Yeah.
And you get closer to actually being able to use Battle Rage on your face.
Yeah, getting an extra card. Out of weapons again.
Oh, no. Just don't armor up anymore.
Yeah, I mean, I feel like there's actually merit. Like, he's probably going to Deathbite off the 5-5 and trade in something. But I think there's merit to not attacking him down to 29, just keeping him at 30.
We'll see if he recognizes that, though. I mean,
I'm sure it'll come into his mind,
yeah.
But he might think, like, oh, what's an extra card? He might not even have Battle Rage.
Yeah.
You know, because eventually you do have to kill your opponent, but he has a really high health.
Yeah.
I guess we're going to see a Shield Slam here if this is happening.
Yeah.
I like that play. I mean, I think it's better than Dust Biting. It's just a lot more mana efficient.
Something to really set up for Dust Bite either, unless he wants to try and get another draw out of this Acolyte, but he can do that anyway because he's protecting it with the Sludge Filter.
So he's just going to attack him. He gets 3 damage.
3 damage adds up.
It does.
I think it's worth it. Kolento has no creatures in play. It's going to take a lot
of
stuff.
It's tough to get a Battle Rage turn in the first place here.
Well, no Mission Mentor is better than nothing. You definitely want card draw in the matchup. In this case, the 2-4 body is kind of irrelevant, but still gets him closer to a good Battle Rage.
He's got no way to get through the Sludge Belcher, though. Like, he's got combo pieces in his hand, but the Warsong Commander for all the Berserker Whirlwind, it's like 10 damage.
Yeah, he just needs to draw Patron.
Yeah.
The main card he's looking for. Patron and Inner Rage. It's like the best draws.
But he's not dealing with anything on the board, so like he's going to start to be put on a clock. He's going to have to not only draw into things on a turn, but then have another turn to be able to play them.
It's not like Control Warrior clocks you that hard. I mean, he still has a lot of time. He has 2 draws here, and if he can draw Grim Patron and Inner Rage, that's really good.
Well, that cuts down the clock pretty significantly. Yeah.
That'll clock you.
Definitely. I mean, Domdus is pretty far ahead to begin with, but this draw is definitely going to cement it.
Yeah.
I don't see any other play here. You have to Alexstrasza.
Man, I don't think Blizzard can make it any more obvious. Like, turn 9, here you go.
Someone's watching over. They're saying, this series has had enough. Give him an Alexstrasza.
Yeah, I might have traded. I guess trading, that's fine.
it protects your Sludge Belcher more.
Yeah, you definitely want to make a trade on that. It's just you want to do Armor Smith into it or Acolyte into it. I'm really surprised you didn't, Alex, though.
Yeah, it's interesting to play. It's going to give Kolento one more turn, one more draw.
And Deathbite's a good draw.
Yeah, it's definitely going to help out.
What's the reason why you think he wouldn't go for Alex there?
I have talked about how Domdus is more of a defensive player. Mm-hmm. He definitely likes taking safer lines. Like, if he thinks in his head right now that he can just win by outlasting, I think that's his preferred route.
Yeah.
But, yeah, I mean, Alex draws a... You always use it on your opponent in this matchup, so turn 9 before you deal any damage seems like literally the perfect time.
Yeah.
The only thing he lost out on, or he would have lost out on by Alexing, is you can't clear the 2-4 with the Deathbite. But who cares?
Clint's deciding this is the turn to Battle Rage. He's got a pretty good one. He can get through the Sludge Belcher, he can get the Frothing Berserker damage down. Yeah. Definitely not bad.
And the point you made earlier, you said if you're emptying your hand, you better be refilling it instantly or killing him.
Right.
As a Patron Warrior.
This is sort of a mixture.
Yeah.
Well, let's see if he gets Execute. If he does, would he even play it? Whirlwind could be good. It's,
It'd be a lot of extra damage, but
it's only, like, 3 extra damage, because the Whirlwind on his guys gives him armor as well.
Oh, yeah, that's true.
And you're not even close to killing him.
Well, Clento's got him all the way down to 50.
Yeah.
He's making progress. Oh, the unstable ghoul.
So, pretty snap execute on that. Didn't really think about it too much.
I would just trade off minions and Alex, I think, but there's a lot of lines of play here that pretty safe.
Yeah. I mean, Alex never gets better. It just gets worse as the game goes on.
Yeah, it's worse now than it was.
Yeah,
last
exactly.
Turn, quite a bit, actually.
And, like, think about if he Alex last turn, it's not like Raynan said, he got an extra turn, essentially. Mm-hmm. He just Alex last turn, it's not like he could have Battle Raged.
Yeah, he would have been at, like, what,
he'd
9
been at,
health?
He'd been at, like, 9 health with an 8-8. Yeah. And a Deathbite in hand, so he'd just be dead.
Yeah.
But instead, he's just at 50. So, that's okay, too.
Well, I guess he's going to draw as many cards off Acolyte as he can. Needs to find BGH or Execute.
Yeah. The main issue here is, like, it looks good to Commander here, but that's a second one. And once that gets cleared and your opponent's at still 50, you're kind of out of the game.
Yeah.
So he's going to go for it anyway, but this could go very badly. He's not going to get much off this.
Yeah, it feels like he's sort of getting his tools sporadically. And so he's throwing them out there to try and draw into more things. Like, he's using his Whirlwind effects not for combos, but to try and draw into his combos. So by the time he gets to his combos,
yep,
he's sort of out of effects.
It's kind of the weakness of these combo decks is if you get pressured enough, you have to start throwing out combo pieces just like randomly just to stay alive.
Yeah. Then you eventually run out of damage.
Yep.
He's going to use the Whirlwind instead of the Deathbite charge and trade in, it looks like.
It's like the last Whirlwind he had in his deck besides this Deathbite charge.
In the War Song too, he's going to lose the War Song.
Yep. And Domdus still has Brawl, so not even close. He's one off lethal.
I still think you play Grommash and armor
get
up.
Get him. Yeah.
But what's the safest play you could possibly make here?
That
because
is
that's
true.
Probably what Domdus
is
going to do.
This is Domdus.
We can Shield Maiden and Unstable Ghoul.
I think the safest play unstable. Is just armor. That's actually the safest.
Yeah, it's true.
Kill that off in your armor. That's it. How do you lose? You cannot lose.
I'll just wait for him to run out of cards, and then I'll kill him.
That actually works. Your opponent's out of charge damage entirely.
Yeah. He's thinking, armor up? Let me look at my notes. Yep. It says here, armor up.
Yeah, he's going to go with the Shield Maiden instead. Really safe play. I don't think Grom's going to deal more than 10 damage, so I would have liked to see it thrown out there. Especially because Shield Maiden's just going to die to this Deathbite.
I'll tell you what it's going to do. It's going to clear a minion. That's the Domdus way.
Yep. So I didn't use the Alex on that turn because he's so used to using it defensively.
So Kolento realizes, you know, all in or nothing, basically.
Yeah.
Pretty dead. Maybe hero power, actually?
Yep. Yeah, I mean, if his minions get killed off, he can't win anyway, so yeah. That makes sense. So.
Yep.
How many cards does Kolento have left? I wonder.
Well, he can't clear them all.
No, this is actually about as good as he could have hoped for from Domdus. Domdus gave Clint a lot of extra time.
11.
To the point where now he doesn't really have a clean way to clear this.
Yeah, even just gromming the Warsong last turn, leaving him with the weapon charge, that way he can brawl and clear off whatever is left.
Or just kill him this turn with Grom that he
might
not have a way to deal with.
Yeah.
Is this game losable for Domdus?
I think it...
Probably not.
It's like...
It's slightly possible.
Like it. I mean, he's going to draw three cards. Or not. I'm not sure how many cards left in Kolento's deck.
There was 11 in Domdus. Oh, two cards.
All right, probably don't want to play battery.
Yeah. What two cards are left? We haven't seen Thorsand.
He only has two?
Yeah, he's two cards. Thorsand?
Oh.
Mm-hmm. And
he played Thorsand already.
It can't be losable then. Yeah. I have no idea what cards are left. I think one's an execute. One's an inner rage, maybe. I don't think we've seen that.
We saw one inner rage on an acolyte earlier.
Oh yeah.
For draw. So.
Don't know if he plays two. We know he plays two dread corsairs. Do we see two of those?
Oh, we saw one.
I don't think we saw both.
Yeah.
So dread corsair or execute.
We've seen at least one and less than three.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Thanks, DJ.
No problem.
So are we throwing Acolyte into the brawl? Poor guy.
He held off on the brawl last turn.
Well, Acolyte never does anything from here on out. Yeah. So.
Kolento could win that way. If Dom just armors every turn for the rest of the game, he will lose. That's his only play.
Oh, wow. As if there were a question. Will he win? Yes.
That basically sums up how this game went.
Yeah.
Inner Rage.
It's the Inner Rage. I think the last card is the Dread Corsair.
Yeah. There's not much that he can do. He can't Battle Rage, so he basically has four cards remaining.
Yeah, I mean, you just Inner Rage your patron and armor. Save the weapon.
Yep. It's the only line of play.
That's very optimistic.
I don't like that.
Yeah, I'd like to make another patron.
Yeah.
Hoping that he just has no way to deal with this 5-2 and this 3-3.
Well, that's unfortunate. Mm-hmm. Even just Sylvanas wins him the game.
Jeez. Gorhal's pretty strong with double brawl. It makes sense.
Yeah.
I have no time for games. So he will go with Sylvanas.
And cards, and the last one is...
I think Dread Corsair.
It's like a guessing game.
Oh, Deathspite. Man, it was a Deathspite?
Wow. Wrong all along.
Oh, wow. Ranked 26 casters.
Alrighty, well, he goes ahead and concedes, and Domdus takes a victory in game number one. Two wins away from securing his spot in that round of eight, in that playoff stage. And Kolento's sort of on the ropes now. He won his first match of the group, 3-0. He was looking like he was in a dominant position, and he hasn't won a game since then.
Yeah, it's definitely been a tough run. He seems to still be playing well, so I don't think it's tilted him too much. But
yeah,
I mean, to be fair, it's a really bad matchup for Kolento. Like, as long as Dom just draws a weapon there to not get overrun in the early game by a quick Frothing Berserker or something, then it's just like really tough for Kolento to find a way to win. I mean, at a certain point, it just becomes impossible for the patron to deal enough damage.
Yeah. So, Domdus still has... what were the other two decks?
He still has... Did he bring Paladin? No, he brought Druid. And...
Did he have Hunter?
No.
No.
He had Handlock. Yeah.
Okay.
Druid and Handlock. Both good against patron. Raynad said, I think that last matchup was pretty favored for Domdus, and...
To be fair, though,
probably a deck that was going to win.
Yeah.
So
He's playing like a double brawl list and some unique classes, so maybe his plan is to just sweep patron. Like, maybe these are the three decks he brought that he thinks have the most favored patron matchups. I mean, a lot of people definitely believe that Handlock has a good patron matchup, and
yeah,
Druid. I mean, I guess if you're playing some acidic ooze shenanigans, you could beat patron as well, but I'm not sure exactly what about that list would make it favored.
I think he had ooze in the Handlock, but not Druid. Probably had Harrison.
This lineup from Kolento does not match up that well against Domdus. He's got Priest potentially against Handlock. He's got like Patron Warrior potentially against Control Warrior. Then he has, it's Demon Zoo. So Demon Zoo matches up pretty good.
Priest basically has to win against Druid. Yep. The other two matchups are really bad.
Yeah.
And I mean, one of them's already out. So.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's definitely going to be an uphill battle for Kolento, just matchup wise.
Yeah, he definitely didn't bring Priest as a Handlock counter, and he got the group with a lot of Handlock in it. It's pretty unfortunate.
I figured that Handlock would actually be pretty popular. Talking to a lot of players, they said Handlock was probably the deck that they thought they'd see the most besides Patron Warrior and some form of Hunter.
Right. The thing about that, though, is like if you get the Hunter matchup, you 100% lose, and if you get the Patron matchup, you're like 60% favored.
Yeah.
So overall, it's just not the best call, I think.
100% win as opposed to 60% favorite. I'll take the the lower.
Which one are you take, DJ?
I don't know.
I'll keep the Molten. They know each other's lists, right? More
or
less. Yeah,
they've seen each other play.
Yeah.
Molten's incredible in this matchup. They have no burst.
Yeah.
Tiny win.
It is kind of the slower Zoo list, but
that's actually a pretty good hand against Zoo.
Yeah, it's all right. I mean, Hellfire's not what it used to be. You play Void Color, Ruby, and Egg.
Especially
on
with this hand.
An Imp Gang boss.
Yeah.
Of the four creatures in Zoo's hand, it kills one of them. The one drop that's going to deal 12 damage before Hellfire comes down. It's a... AoE's just not where you want to be anymore against aggressive decks. Like, double Iron Beak Owl is a better place.
Yeah.
Goes it's a with great an drop. Aggressive Ancient Watcher. Yeah, Doomguard is insane here.
It's going to guarantee that he has a strong minion off the Void Caller, but Molten Giant's an important pickup for Handlock here for sure. And it seems like Kolento doesn't have a way to buff his minion and trade into Ancient Watcher, but killing Owl is just as good, pretty much.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, he's really going to want to pick up, like, some way to buff the Egg. Oh, especially now.
He could Bane of Doom his own egg.
Feel like...
There.
That's perfect.
It's tough to make that play over Void Caller, but... I mean, what do you expect next turn in Twilight Drake? Maybe he goes for it. Honestly, it puts 6 power into play instead of 3, which is pretty good.
Well, we see that there's an Owl on the other side, so...
Which
if
makes
you,
this play
yeah.
not as good in this circumstance.
Yeah.
But.
Like, we're going to see a Life Tap Owl.
Yeah.
On the Void Caller, probably.
There's no reason to sort of give him free activation.
Yeah, a lot of players do bluff the Void Caller, but it's... like we've talked about, Domdus does not take risks.
I don't know if it's like ever intentional to bluff the void Caller.
Yeah, a lot of times you just have to, kind of. Like,
I'm going
to
put out the Void
you
Caller.
You need a 3-4.
Hope he either doesn't kill it until I draw a demon, or...
I don't know if I like this play instead of killing the Nerubian Egg.
Yeah.
It also would have been a stronger play to roll a Mel'Ganis instead of a Void Caller. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, for sure. I definitely agree with that
misplay line. From Kolento.
Yeah. Surprised he made that one. Maybe playing on Big Game Hunter. Mm.
Double Doomguard is awkward.
Oh, there's Owl, but
this is
not
the
awkward,
turn.
Yeah.
Play it. I guess maybe Defender just in Ruby and Egg.
Yeah, you could do that. I mean, if you Defender the 3-3, it gets eaten really easily, and then you don't get Owl value, so you're committed to not Owling that Drake.
You can also just Implosion and go face.
Yeah.
Not too weak to Hellfire, because you have the Nerubian Egg on the board to sort of protect yourself from that.
Too weak to Hellfire, Mortal Coil.
Whoa. Yeah, it's true.
Which he has.
He has! Would you look at that?
Would you look at that? Yeah, I mean, it's not going to get any easier going into the late game for Kolento, especially with the double Doomguard draw.
Yeah.
He's going to look through all his options, decide what he thinks is the best. Iron Beak Owl plus Face, I suppose, is what he goes with here. No, I guess a trade plays around Shadow Flame.
Okay. But just going to get Mountain Giant instead.
Yeah, it's a pretty good draw.
Yep.
Well,
with no board whatsoever, going to be tough.
I like the double Owl in his list.
Yeah.
It's not going to work out here, but it's a good build, I think. So he's got to decide between Defender. I don't think Doomguard's the play.
Yeah, though Doomguard is just going to die. What are you going to do, 5 damage to Face and then get it killed and also discard?
Yeah.
You have to sort of just like stall for a better play. He does have Knife Juggler plus Implosion next turn. So that might be able to give him a little bit of a swing back into the game, but it's going to be tough, especially if there's a threat played this turn. We can see that there's not really one, actually. Can't play the Molten Giant yet.
Yeah. He might end up just Dark Bombing the 1-3 egg. He's out of Owls, and Kolento knows that. So many
possibilities. Could even Life Tap double Dark Bomb. Just have a clear board and an 8-4.
Yeah. That is a little weak to what Kolento has.
Yeah, Implosion.
He's going to build a wall.
Oh, there
go
we go.
Face. Yeah. Well, going Face against Zoo reduces their freedom of Life Tapping a lot. Yeah. So.
Well, he can sort of push through here. He's got Knife Juggler, Implosion, plus a Power Overwhelming.
Yeah, you just check your RNG first and then see if you need to power. You probably don't.
I guess you shoot the Ancient Watcher, Silence the 8-8.
I wonder. I don't know. Silence the 8-8, it's pretty risky. Just leaving it up.
Yeah, but if you Knife Juggle an Implosion into the 8-8, what if it doesn't match up?
You'll probably get there.
You'll get there eventually.
You're behind. You need to at least roll like 3 or 4, get some decent knives, trade in the 4-4.
So yeah. Possibilities.
Maybe you lead with the Power Overwhelming, so you don't waste juggles.
Yeah, it could be a possibility.
Yeah,
power Overwhelming the 4-4.
Well, you could even PO the 2-3. But
oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
It's pretty ugly, like, no matter what, unless you get really good RNG.
Yeah, if you...
He's just going to lead with the RNG. Yep. Go for the Watcher.
Well, he got it.
He got it. That's what you're looking to get.
He wants, like...
He wants the right to. Yeah. Oh. Well, this is good enough.
That's pretty decent.
Yeah, no wasted juggles.
Yeah.
No board either,
he's still pretty dead. Yeah.
All of that fuss for pretty much nothing. Dom is just going to Hellfire.
All right, you tap first.
Yeah.
Maybe you don't want a Hellfire,
yeah, I don't know about that. I'm going to leave these creatures up on the board and maybe just play an Antique Healbot.
Yeah. Why not?
All right. He's going to go with the Hellfire. No board, though. So Kolento keeps initiative.
Yeah. But doesn't have great stuff to play quite yet.
Wow, that is a terrible hand.
I think he plays Dr. Boom, though. So if he can tap into that...
I might actually do it.
Yeah, that'd be... probably his best chance, and then you could even double Doomguard next turn, potentially.
I wonder. I can guess how that's going to work out.
No.
Well, I think you Void Terror Imp Gang, boss. Hope that no taunts or heals are played. And then double Doomguard.
That's how you get him. Yeah.
Can't even double Doomguard next turn. He's only got...
No, he can.
Yeah.
So
Dom just needs to Life Tap Dr. Boom for Kolento to have a 1-in-3 chance of winning. I think that's almost the only way that is.
That is not a Domdus play.
No, it's going to be like Dark Bomb, Defender, my Sun Fury. I don't know. There we go. Okay, so he has Healbot, Molten. I guess he Molten, Sun Fury, Dark Bomb.
That looks to be what he's going for. Got the silence. He'd be. If you can tap into PO abusive.
Nope.
That would be. No, he wouldn't have enough mana.
There's lethal on board, too. He's just dead next turn.
He can kill the. He can put up a Void Walker.
Yeah.
Or kill the 2/3 somehow. I don't know.
He's definitely going to at least tap.
Yeah, you got to tap.
So maybe you tap after you play the three cards on the right.
And now he's... We know he's dead for sure.
Yeah, I mean, Kolento's going to take a risky line of play because he's behind and it's just not quite going to pay off.
So yeah. Kolento is on the verge of going down 2-0.
Yeah, the problem here is you can't Doomguard, so...
To be fair, this is another abysmal matchup for Kolento. This version of like Zoo is not that aggressive, and I mean, if you're like trading blows mid-game with Antlock, it's just not going to keep up with 0 mana 8/8s.
Yeah.
No big game hunter or anything like that. You have to go through all his minions the hard way.
Yeah.
We talked about Priest being the weak link for Kolento, but I think Druid's the weak link for Domdus. It has unfavorable matchups against pretty much everything that... Kolento has.
That's true. Kolento has Patron Warrior.
Priest. And the Zoo.
And the Zoo Lock.
That's
a
good point, yeah. I mean, Kolento is actually still has a very good chance of winning this series.
Yeah.
Even though he's down 0-2. Do we know specifically like what version of Druid it is?
It's Fast Druid, I believe. So, I think...
It's going to be tough.
Domdus has to think it's good against Patron. The rest of his lineup's pretty good against Patron.
Well, there was always that, Druid can pull out wins against anything.
Right.
And Priest can pull out losses against anything. So.
Yeah.
Definitely.
Priest is pretty good against Druid, though.
Yeah,
it's definitely one of the matchups you want.
I mean, Dom just does have three games in which to draw Wild Growth, though.
Yeah.
So that is a lot of opportunity for outplaying.
Yeah, he could pull a Lead Paint and go a whole series without even seeing a Wild Growth. Not even in his opening hand.
Wow.
A whole series without seeing one throughout every single game, which is actually was against Kolento. So Kolento's got a sort of that hidden skill of being able to force his opponents to not draw into Wild Growth.
His opponents actually have not drawn Wild Growth against him this tournament.
Wow.
0/3.
There's a statistic for you.
Sure, his Druid win percentage is pretty good.
Yeah. He like tried to talk his opponents out of playing Wild Growth with his smooth Ukrainian voice. It's not that smooth.
Nah.
Very Ukrainian though.
You have a Kolento impression?
No. I'm not gonna go there. I liked your life coach impression though.
I don't have one either.
Raynad, are we 0-3? You don't have a Kolento impression for us?
No, comrade.
Yeah, there's the Harrison. Might come in handy against Patron later if it gets to that.
Is he considering keeping Keeper? Right, I don't like Keeper.
I don't know why you'd keep that.
Maybe you're just really scared of Velen's Chosen.
Yeah.
But you should know Kolento's list.
If he pays attention, he knows Kolento doesn't play that card.
I think in like 90% of matchups, you just hard mulligan from Wild Growth. What else?
No Wild Growth, though.
No, but he does have Innervate, Dr. Boom.
He's still going to need that Wild Growth for that hand to be...
Yeah. Actually, Kolento has not played Light Bomb in the past. And we didn't see it this tournament, so Domdus has no info on that.
Yeah, that's true.
Oof.
And that is killer against Druid.
Turn 2, Hero Power Face, the sign of some weak Druid play.
Yeah. Kolento kept Thought Steal, and he's not going to get punished for it. He's just going to get a clean Thought Steal off.
Yeah, it's pretty good against Druid, honestly. I mean, I can't fault him for keeping it. You're not always going to get early game minions, especially in a list like Kolento's. So.
Force of Nature.
Yeah, Kolento's hand was actually really slow, but so is Domdus's, so that favors the Priest.
Now, clearly the Druid's ahead, though. Kolento's at 28.
Yeah, 32.
Yeah. So it's looking good, is what you're saying.
You know it's bad when the Priest plays a Shade before you.
Yeah. Oh!
That's not bad.
That's fantastic.
That's good, yeah.
Get that sucker out there right
now. Really good.
Mm-hmm.
Does Kolento not have an answer for it?
No answer.
Wow.
Needs to draw death off the top.
This is amazing. If this gets two triggers, all of a sudden Domdus is right back
That's
in it.
Better than a Wild Growth.
Oh, yeah. All right, So it just drew three innervates.
Sure.
It lives
sure.
again. It's three more.
Death off the top? No.
Ouch.
Literally no answer.
Literally.
Yeah. Not even a really inefficient play he could do.
Mm-hmm. Like a figurative no answer.
Oh, man.
There we go. Boom.
Yeah, that's the figurative no answer.
Well, if the 5-5 lived, the 7-7 definitely will.
Light bomb.
Yeah, light bomb's actually a pretty good way to deal with this.
And the slime lives to soak a bomb.
So sick.
I think he kind of might have to.
He's thinking about
what
a way that he could do it. Can he force of nature?
Clint's going to take his time and think through his
options.
Yeah,
he can force a nature,
yeah. That might be better to save the light bomb for later.
Yeah, light bomb does kind of get better.
Force of nature might not.
We see a zombie chow in Domdus' hand.
That is not what you want against Priest, for sure.
Or Patron.
Yeah, right. Surprising it's in his deck, actually, if his plan is to have a solid anti-Patron lineup.
Yeah.
You always got to think about Hunters, though.
Yeah, I mean, I feel like a lot of players in this tournament have been trying to kind of go both ways with their tech choices. And
you have to pick one or the other.
Yeah, you have to pick, basically. It's more about consistency than it is all around.
So it's good to do one thing great as opposed to doing a bunch of things pretty good.
Looks like he's going with Light Bomb. Yeah, this is Light Bomb.
All right.
Well, he stops the bleeding, but
Emperor definitely did his damage.
Yeah, Domdus still has initiative. He's got lots of reduced costs. He's gonna creatures. He's gonna be able to play a 5 mana.
Yeah,
Ancient of Lore.
Domdus has draw 4 in his hand. Now down to draw 2 with an 8-card hand already.
Yeah, playing Ancient of Lore on turn 6 into
not gonna
scenarios
run out of gas
on
for a long time.
There's no reason to drop Chow because it's gonna make it a little bit harder to combo the Priest, give it a target for Cabal Shadow Priest, so might as well hold on to it. And if I'm Kolento, I'd probably play Sludge Belcher.
I wonder.
Yeah, Sylvanas feels like it could get a lot more.
Well, Sylvanas is just awful here, yeah.
What about Force of Nature?
That's not the worst.
Just clearing. I mean, if you keep one for wanting the druid, you will lose. So he's looking to set up a turn where he can swing the board, because the druid is pretty bad at swinging back the board.
This is such a powerful hand.
Yeah.
There's so many different ways to wreck your opponent. I mean, I guess I would go with Azurdrake Keeper. That again, that would give a Cabal Shadow Priest target, so I don't know if that's the best option.
You can Azure Drake, innervate, swipe. Yeah.
That would also die to Arcanine Circle.
Just play scenarios.
It's not the worst. Go scenarios, you could innervate the Keeper as well if you wanted.
He could play most combinations of his card that fit 7 mana.
I think he'd still be in a pretty
good spot.
10 options here.
Yeah.
That all put him in good spots.
Mm-hmm.
So it looks like he's just gonna like pace himself, basically, not go too all in, because again, the priest has to do something crazy to come back.
Yeah.
I'd like to see Shredder. All right, so Arcanine Circle definitely gonna be the play for Kolento here.
Yep.
Although I have said that before when casting his games, and he ended up being really conservative with his cards.
You could force a nature here.
Pretty much casting Kolento playing Priest is the hardest thing you'll ever do, because all the options for plays you go for, it feels like he always does like the opposite.
Not this time.
Oh, now he could pick it off too.
Yeah, will he do that over Light of Naru? I think so. I think he just wants to save the Light of Naru for the second Akanai, the way that I've seen him play Priest before.
Mm-hmm.
But he might just
want to have a second creature on board.
Yeah.
Is it playing anything? It plays into Swipe.
Must consider.
Not too bad, because it's only 3-1, which you could have just hero powered off anyway.
Yeah, I mean, it would give the druid a keeper target, but that's not the biggest deal.
He might want a keeper target, yeah. So he can actually take a keeper with Cabal Shadow Priest. Jockey, I know you play a lot of Priest.
I did once upon a time.
Before, I know it's the deck that...
Before Patron came out and, you know, made it not very good.
You're sort of the opposite of other players. In public, you play Hunter.
Yeah.
But when nobody's watching behind closed doors, you play Priest.
It's okay. I don't think it's top three. I wouldn't bring it to.
I think it's
a
pretty standard
tournament.
TJ. I think most people play Hunter in public. Very few of them play Priest in tournaments.
Yeah.
But the ones that do, man, like Kolento's had a really good record with it. Like, yeah, with this specific list, that he just doesn't change ever.
He won some French tournament and he just like destroyed everyone as Priest.
Yeah.
Just didn't drop a game with it. Threw 7 rounds of Swiss and then an entire double limb bracket.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah, I remember that. It was sort of at the beginning of this year, maybe a couple months ago.
Yep. So
he won his Legendary Series week as well, playing Priest. He had Priest the week that he won.
I would definitely play it a lot myself if I had that kind of record with
exactly.
it.
Exactly. Like, when you have success with something so much, you really, it's hard to just say no.
Yeah.
There still is a degree of, like, comfort decks and stuff that just kind of fits your style, bringing that. I think, honestly, that's a lot of Druid players right now. Yeah. Like, don't feel it's, like, the best deck ever. But people, as a third deck, you have to pick something.
People talk about players and comfortability levels. They say, oh, well, why don't you bring the best deck? Well, sometimes it's better to bring a deck that you've mastered that may not be the best.
Right.
Than to bring the best deck that you may not have played before. Unless you're Raynad.
We talk about how well he plays it.
Yeah.
This game isn't too far out of his reach.
Yeah, that's not really an intuitive play either, what he just did, but it's definitely correct. Like, Kolento just plays Sylvanas on a board where the Druid can trade, like,
one and a half cards for it.
Right, but he knows that he hasn't seen a keeper yet, so he knows that Sylvanas is just getting keepered, so you might as well...
Yeah, play it as a 5-5.
Yeah.
Try and leverage the board back.
That or he could hold it until he's fatigued, but it's not as good of a strategy. Well, Scenarios definitely fixes the Zombie Chow problem of drawing it late game, and I think I would definitely do that if I were Domdus right here.
Yeah.
He hesitated a little bit. You don't usually click that +2/+2 button.
Yeah, Yetis are pretty strong against Priest.
Yeah.
And 4/6s.
Yeah. Well, Death can hit the 5/8 for sure. The other two are pretty hard to clear.
He can, like, Force of Nature...
You have to have Blademaster, Light of Nauru this turn for sure.
Yeah, I think so. You get a 4/7 and a 5/2.
Consider.
You know the 5/2's pretty likely to die to something.
Yeah.
But you can see he's scrolling over his opponent's deck right now. Probably like think about the odds of combo and the different like damage thresholds. Because if you don't kill anything and you heal your Blademaster, your opponent has 26.
Yeah.
So he could heal himself to go to 27, but he also knows his opponent has gotten Emperor activation, so 27 is 27 anyway.
Yeah.
So you just have to completely disrespect it at this point. Mm. Just ignore combo entirely.
So injured Blade Master, Light of the Nauru, Shadow or Death.
Yeah, and probably heal the Blade Master for 1. You could heal yourself to try to.
Does it matter if you heal the Blade Master for 1? Is it being at 7 health a bit much bigger deal than being at 6 health?
Kolento doesn't think so.
I mean, kind of changes it with Savage Roar, but that card's not getting played unless Kalento's dead, so.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, there's the Wild Girls.
There they are.
They've been saving up.
The 18th cards. 18th and 19th or something.
They sensed that the day was almost over. So they took a little peek out of their hiding place.
Yeah. And this is probably, like, the worst time to draw them, besides very, very mid-game.
I would like to see Savage Roar played here, I think.
Yeah.
Just to clear off, you're able to clear with your face for the Light Warden, too?
Yeah, and you play Harrison.
Mm.
You're still not too vulnerable to Light Bomb.
Yeah.
I'd put the damage on Keeper of the Grove, I think.
And I mean, he drew the other Savage, so.
Yeah. Bring the Keeper of the Grove down to 2 health. Not really anything that threatens that.
Yeah, you just don't want your zombie chow to die.
Yeah.
It's a very real possibility that that card survives the rest of the game.
Yeah, one thing that Kolento's really lacked this game was his Shrinkmeisters. Like,
yeah,
would be huge at this point.
He actually had a potential to keep one in his opening. But it's not something
it's not really a keep card, yeah.
Yeah, it's something you want to draw in the mid game. It. Yeah.
Yeah. Domdus very hesitant to Savage Roar, but does it. Do we get the attack? Yep.
Okay. Oh, those mechanics.
You got it all off, yeah.
Who says you don't need APM in Hearthstone? You do when you are indecisive in rope and have to make the plays at the last second.
Yeah. Force of Nature clears off a lot here.
Yeah, definitely a solid
and
play.
And then if you draw, like, Shrinkmeister next turn, you can take the Keeper.
Yeah.
This game looked so bad for Kolento, but, I mean, right now it looks winnable.
Yeah. There's a chance.
Right. Druid has to brick. It's a very small chance, but...
Yeah.
Druid has to draw, like, Wrath here or something. Or Swipe. That's that's a brick, though. I have
no time. Like, you can't really keep her face. So...
Because you know one of those cards that you've been holding on to since nearly the beginning of the game is Cabal Shadow Priest.
Death would be a good top deck as well.
Yeah, Death, Shrinkmeister. Does he play Mind Control?
That's not good.
We haven't seen
Mind Control. We saw Ysera, though.
Can't really play Ysera until he deals with the Sylvanasus on the board.
Not very good for him. Opponent bricked, but so did he.
Yeah, Kolento needed to be drawing live for the rest of the game, I think.
Yep.
Oof. Well, here's what we see. First of all, let's make sure
that's
the game's not over. Yeah, it's not. So, Domdus is going to decide how much he wants to play into things that could catch the Priest up, like Light Bomb, Akanai Circle. So he's going to most likely play Druid of the Claw with Taunt and Swipe. But he can also keep her in Hero Power. Maybe. I mean, saving Druid of the Claw for Savage Roar could make some sense. All right, he's not going to respect the second...
second Light Bomb, yeah.
I mean, Circle of Healing here.
I don't think it would do that much.
It looks like he's dead.
Yeah, he'd be dead even with Circle.
He's dead just to the board. Can't even do it.
Yeah. And so another...
Wow!
3-0, then 0-3. Another 0-3 for Kolento.
That's rough, and Kolento, he's out of the tournament.
One of the favorites, I would say.
That's actually a pretty big deal, and Domdus has to be really proud of himself. He's had a long day.
Right.
He lost his first matchup and then had to fight his way through sort of that loser's bracket of his group, but he had some really great matches, and he's going to actually earn himself a spot in that round of 8. Kolento, though, won't be seeing any more of him.
Yep.
Maybe hanging out around the studios throughout the next couple of days, but as far as tournament play goes, he's out.
Yeah, I mean, I think his like gameplay decisions were good. I mean, maybe the lineup wasn't the best one to bring, and he did definitely get unlucky in a lot of parts there in the last couple matches. But yeah, that is just the worst way to go out in a tournament where you like lose 6 matches in a row.
Yeah,
you know? Like it's just like in tournaments where it's like double elimination and you win a bunch in a row and then you lose your last one. You feel kind of bad about it. But if you lose one and then you win your last one, you feel really good. So it's I've definitely been there. It's a rough way to go out. But
He started off the day super strong. And we were looking at the interviews from the players early on in the day, and they were saying, oh, yeah, Kolento, probably the player to watch for this first set of groups. Kolento and Life Coach. Kolento today, Life Coach tomorrow.
Domdus said... You know, he was coming in with a mentality of he's the best player in the tournament.
Yeah, he said you have to.
So
if you want to win, you have to sort of think that you're the best.
Yeah, I mean, on some level, I think everybody kind of respects Kolento as this is going to be hard.
Yeah. Yeah, definitely. So what do you think are Domdus' chances moving forward into the playoff stage? He had, with his deck lineup, he had sort of a rough road early on, but picked it up as the day went on.
Well, his lineup seems to be pretty good against Patron.
Yeah.
And in the top 8 so far, we've got one patron. So.
Yep.
Very surprising results, kind of.
Yeah, I mean, I definitely expect that deck to do better, but it's not like. It's not like patron's been getting the wins when it's present, I feel like. It's not like the deck's been getting swept.
Yeah, it might be like a lineup issue.
Right, yeah.
There were a lot of people with bad third decks, essentially.
Exactly, yeah.
And players have been sort of catering their lineups towards countering Patron Warrior, so. a lot of the games that Patron Warrior has been losing have been because they were up against like Handlock or something that does really well
against
it. Yeah.
That game, like 30% chance of lethal though.
I heard there was a Sylvanas kind of like chance of lethal earlier.
There's been a lot of lethal opportunities that have been passed upon so far today. But we do have a winner's interview ready with Domdus on the stage. So let's send it over to Dan.
That's right, DJM, joined by the second place runner-up here from Group B. Domdus, you did make it through and you got to 3-0 Kolento, which means you kept up a pretty insane streak to be able to get this momentum here. So what's your initial thoughts here advancing into round of eight in second place?
I'm just super excited. It was a great day, a lot of fun matches. I'm also like really tired. It's pretty late now. It was great playing Kolento. I'm happy I got a 3-0. I think I got a lot of really good top decks. Like I think I top decked Emperor a couple of times when I had Innervate and stuff. So he played really well though, but RNGesus was just on my side today.
Well, we'll see on day three, but you do have tomorrow off, so good job there. You know, some of the fans I was reading through the forums, they were saying that they felt like you played the most solid overall today, despite the good and the bad luck may have come in your way or not your way. How do you feel about that? Do you feel like you played your best, or do you agree or disagree with that statement?
My first match against Kit Kats, I thought I was a little bit uneven in my play. There were some plays that were definitely better than the plays that I made, and I knew it immediately after making them, so that was disappointing. But I think I got a little more of a groove after that when I played Lead Paint and then Kolento. So I think my decision-making was pretty sound for the second two matches, definitely.
You'll be playing up against a first seed, which means if it's not Demigod, it'll be a player from Group C or D. But seeing how everyone else has played so far, how do you feel are your chances going to the round of eight?
I feel really confident. I think I played pretty well. Hopefully I can sustain that throughout the weekend and get a little bit more rest this time instead of staying up too late last night. But I think I have pretty good chances. There are a lot of really great players in Group C and D, though. I would have to say those are probably the harder groups of this weekend. So there's definitely a lot of tough competition in this, no doubt.
In terms of smooth, wavy hair that has a nice little swoosh to it, how do you compare your hair to Raynad's hair? Because I know that he is very adamant against the use of hair product. What do you use, if anything at all, and do you find that it's better to use blow-dried hair or a hair product?
I need to take a closer look at Raynad's hair to compare, but it looks pretty sexy from over here. I
have his phone number. I'll give it to you later.
Actually, I have his phone number as well, funny enough. When I played him in the Legendary series, he thought I was an admin, so I ninja'd his number, and he gave it to me, and it was great. He got wrecked pretty hard, so I got that number too, so no worries about that. But I've been told that I shouldn't use, wax? Right now I use gel, but you know, it doesn't let, the grills told me that they need to be able to run their hands through my hair without having resistance, so I should switch over to wax. But right now I'm using gel. It gives it a little shiny look, which but it's all right.
It's a very wet look. I personally use hair fiber myself, but it's whatever. I mean, it's all the same. And the girls are included in terms of winning the ESL Legendary Series, so good luck with that. All right, well, that wraps up our last interview of the day. We want to say goodbye with our commentators before we send it back here to tell you about what's going to happen tomorrow. So once again, we give it over to the desk and the boys, and we'll see what they have to say.
All righty, thanks, Dan. Raynad, is that what the grills say?
So much hair product heresy right there that I just heard. Don't get me started on it, man.
You're going to have a little conversation with Domdus after the show's over.
Yep, over a romantic candlelit dinner, maybe.
Yeah. Jockey, what about you? What is your stance on hair product?
You know, I don't use any, so I guess I'm on Team Raynad.
There you go, man. Yeah. Okay, redeeming qualities.
All right. Well, I guess we're going to take a look at the schedule for the rest of the weekend. And for tomorrow, of course, we saw Group A and Group B today, where we saw Demigod, Trump, Kit Kats, and Domdus qualify for that playoff stage for that round of eight. Tomorrow, we're going to start off with Group C. Raynad is going to take on Roger. Oskaka is going to take on Double Os. And then in Group D, Life Coach, The Rat, Silent Storm, and Phone Tap. So plenty more Hearthstone action is coming throughout the rest of the weekend. And are you excited for your match tomorrow, Raynad? Playing Roger.
Meh. It depends on how late I'm out today, right?
Yeah.
If I wake up, I'm all rested. I'll be good to go. I'll be excited. But, you know, it's not always the case on Saturday morning. So,
right, Chucky, what are you looking – are there any players you're looking out for in Group C&D particularly?
Yeah, I think Group C&D have a lot of great players. I think Group D was actually kind of like – looked to be the most stacked group to me. I got the Rat, Phone Tap, Life Coach, and Silent Storm, last season's champion. So really looking to see how all those players can do. I mean, Group C already starts off Roger versus Reynad. Roger's had a lot of success.
Yeah.
And I'm not quite sure the other matchup is Oskaka and...
Double Os. Yeah.
So a lot of exciting matches tomorrow. I'm really looking forward to it.
Yeah. Well, we'll see what's on the line for these players. We have quite a few prizes to give out. Not only $25,000 prize pool, but we also have quite a few World Championship points to give away, and that includes 100 points to the first place winner. Chucky, how many BlizzCon points do you have?
I think I have 61.
That's pretty good.
Yeah, it's okay.
Andre?
Three? I don't know. Maybe 20.
Maybe 20.
Before we go, Kit Kat specifically requested I not mention he has one BlizzCon point.
Mm. Kit Kat has one BlizzCon point.
It's not very many, is it, TJ?
No.
How many do you have, TJ?
One BlizzCon point. I'll see you guys at BlizzCon at the grand final of BlizzCon.
We're all gonna make it,
man. When I'm facing off against Jockey,
and I
look him in the eye and say, "I took my one BlizzCon point." But that's gonna wrap it up from us on the desk here. So we're gonna send it over back to Dan to close out the day.
Thank you so much, guys. That's right. We're here to close out day number one. A lot of fun games, but in the end, four players were eliminated, as we did have Trump, Demigod, Kit Kats, and Domdus go through the first group stages. Tomorrow promises to be the same exact thing, just as they mentioned. But before we go, we want to let you guys know about how you can stay engaged in the conversation by hashtagging HLS and tweeting at ESL Hearthstone. Let us know your favorite moments throughout the day. There's tons of giveaways and cool promotions going on, too, through our raffle, ESL.gg/season2finals. Make sure to participate so you get an opportunity to win some cool swag thanks to our sponsors, Plantronics and Gigabyte. Thank you so much for everybody who's watching. Tomorrow at 11 a.m. PST, we continue with Group C, Reynad versus Roger, Oskaka versus Doublos. And then Group D, we have Life Coach versus The Rat, and Season 1 Champion, Sandstorm versus PhoneTap. Promises to be just as epic, if not better, tomorrow. So we'll see you guys then. Have a good night.